you are God. Thank you, Lord, because there's no one like you. Amen. We gather here together, Lord, as your word said, we should go out even to preach your word. Father, we are here in this time, Lord, even to preach your word to everyone in this area. We pray, Lord, that you take control in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, we invite you to take absolute control of this environment in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We come against every power that may want to contrary to your word, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you put them into bondage in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, Lord, as you came to this world even to save souls, we pray, Lord, that you save many souls in this area in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everyone that has been sent into captivity, we pray, Lord, that you release them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
At the end of everything, let your name be glorified.
Amen.
Everyone you are going to use, empower them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Give them the wisdom from above, Lord.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Today is a wonderful day.
Amen.
We're here to glorify Jesus. Jesus the Alpha, Alpha and Omega. Jesus the Alpha, Alpha and Omega. So we praise him because he's Alpha, Alpha and Omega. Praise him because he's Alpha, Alpha and Omega. Jesus is Alpha, Alpha and Omega. Jesus is Alpha, Alpha and Omega. We will praise him because he's Alpha, Alpha and Omega. We will praise him because he's Alpha, Alpha and Omega.
The Redeemed Christian Church of God, Fountain of Revival, Street Preachers. Today we are here in Easton to preach the word of God. A lot of terrible things happening, but the Bible says in the book of Psalm 127, 1b, verse 1b, and says that if God does not guard the city, if God does not watch over the city, that the watchman is just awake in vain. Brethren, I just want to say that it is time for us to come together and preach Christ. It is time for us to come together and do the work of God and pray together, because it's only prayer that can save us. And I want you to just sit back and watch as Street Preacher, Fountain of Revival, preach Jesus Christ in Easton. God bless you all.
Hallelujah to Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Easton Station, the people of Easton, to Jesus. Hallelujah to your King. The King is in town. Hallelujah, hallelujah to Jesus, the creator of our souls, the owner of the universe, the Bible in the Zabul, the Bible in the Zabul, Psalm 24, the Bible in the Zabul, Psalm 24. It says the ox is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, and the inhabitants and all those that dwell in the earth. The Zabul, Psalm 24, verse 1. It says the ox is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, the inhabitants and all those that dwell in there. The ox is the Lord, the owner of the ox is in town, Jesus. Jesus is in town. Jesus is in town. The owner of the earth is here. The owner of the universe. The owner of mankind is here. The Bible says that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. That Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. That no one cometh to the Father except through him. What does he mean by Jesus is the way? What does he mean the way? The way. What does he mean? The Bible says Jesus Christ is the way. What does it mean by the way? In John 14:6, the Injil, the Holy Bible, in John 14:6, it says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. What does it mean? What does it mean when the Bible said the way? Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, a way is like a route to a destination. A route to a destination. A way is like an end, a route to achieve an end, a route to achieve an end. And when the Bible says that Jesus is the way, the Bible is saying that Jesus is the way to the end. Jesus is the way to the end. What do we mean by Jesus is the way to the end? The Bible says in the Injil, in the book of Hebrews 9:27, that it is appointed for a man to die once, and after that the judgment. You will die one day on earth. And since you have a beginning, there should be an end. Even the earth has a beginning. The Bible says in the Torah, in the book of Genesis, Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, it says, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth, meaning the earth has a beginning. Everything has a beginning. The earth has a beginning. Even God is called the Alpha, the Omega. God says it's the beginning and is the end. Now every man has a beginning, every man has an end. The Bible says God created man from dust. That was the beginning of man, when God created us from dust. The Bible says in the book of Genesis 1:26-27, God created us in his image, and in the image of God we were created. What does it mean that we are created in God's image? Meaning that God had a plan for us and created us just like him. He created us just like him. And he made us, created us from the dust of the earth. In the book of Genesis 2:7. In the book of Genesis 2:7, the Torah. From that day, God breathed life into man. And man became a living being. That was the beginning of man. Meaning you have a beginning. You have a beginning. The day you were born on earth is the day you started. It's the day you came to earth. Whereas as you have a beginning, there's also a day that will come, an end will come. And that's the day of your death. You are going somewhere. And because you are on a journey, you must know the way to where you are going to end. Have you asked yourself, where am I going to end? Where will I be when I die? For you, sure, you will die one day. For it is appointed for a man to die. No one is escaping that. Everyone will die one day. But do you know when you die, where are you going? Have you resolved, have you asked yourself the question that if I die today, where am I going? The Bible gives